Julius Gabula, an orthopedic technician in Uganda, has come up with a plan to provide people living with disability in the country with cheaper versions of prosthetic limbs. By using recycled plastic, other materials, Gabula is able to make an artificial limb and improve mobility for his clients.
Alan Serugo has an appointment today at a workshop in Kampala that specializes in making prosthetic limbs. Serugo lost his leg in an accident a few years ago. He's here today to see Julius Gabula, a trained orthopedic technician. Gabula wants to see more Ugandan amputees using prosthetics to enable them lead a quality life. He decided to rent space at a garage in the city where he uses recycled plastics and other materials to make affordable versions of prosthetics.
While working on them, it is not a must that you have to fit them, that they should go back to the way they were living before. But we restore them, we rehabilitate them to the extent that they are able to move in a similar way they were moving. However, we cannot, it is not possible to go back to what God made at first.
Story building, marketplaces, because, you know, as an amputee, you have to move in a flat surface area where you don't have to get problems from. And public facilities like toilets, you can't access them because when you find that it's not a sitting toilet, you can't use it. There are lots of challenges which are out there. Public transport, where if you as an amputee, if someone finds you like public means, like taxis, if they find you with clutches, they'll bypass you because they know that you're going to take a lot of time to enter the taxi.
The workshop produces mobility devices used for both hands and legs. The products cost between $200 to $1,300. Similar ones made by established manufacturers go for about double the price in orthopedic outlets in the city. Gabula also allows its customers to pay for the prosthetics in installments. Sometimes he's unable to meet demand for the artificial limbs.
The challenges I face, the one is that materials are very expensive to get. Even when you get them on local market, you get a little, and others you need help. For example, you need a donor to be sponsoring you to get the materials from outside such that you can work on a patient.
About 2 million Ugandans live with disability, according to the country's Ministry of Health. Many have no access to wheelchairs or crutches, making movement difficult. Esther Nakamate has been using a prosthetic leg since 2015 and says it has helped her overcome stigma and also made it easier to go about her daily duties. I thought I had reached the end in life when I lost my leg, but this artificial limb has been very helpful, and the orthopedic technician encouraged me a lot and told me I'd walk and be able to walk again. This all sounded like a dream. I didn't know about artificial limbs, and I thought I would crawl all my life. After I received training on how to use the prosthetic, I'm now able to walk normally. About 150 people are using the prosthetics so far. Gabula is planning to open another workshop in Western Uganda on the border with Congo to cater for victims of war in the neighboring country and enable those affected to become more productive in the society. Janet Chapia, KTN News.